Hello everyone, this is Vibhu Goyal from Electronics and Communication Engineering Department, Government Engineering College, Bharatpur. In the continuation of the lecture series, hope you people remember yesterday we studied about XRD. Today we will understand one more concept that has relevance with the XRD, that is Scherer formula. Hope you people remember in the yesterday's lecture, we understand what are X-rays, how they are used to measure the diffraction. Based on that, we will be able to check which sort of material we are available with. And like on XRD pattern, we will understand from the intensity versus 2 theta graph at which particular theta angle and what intensity we are getting in the peaks. And based on that, with the help of GCPDS file, we will match. And finally, we will be able to deduce that which particular materials are present inside our sample. Now, further, how we can use the XRD data, that we are going to understand today. In the Scherer formula, what it is basically used to calculate the overall grain size. Let us suppose if you are using a nano powder, if you are basically fabricating a thin film or any kind of fabrication you are doing that has a relevance with the device physics. You are always curious about what is the overall size of the grains that that you have deposited. Irrespective of whether you have used the technique of pulse laser deposition or vacuum evaporation or sputtering. So grain size plays a major role, which tells whether the film is of nanometer level or film is thick or thin. This all we will understand with the help of this grain size. So this formula was given by Scherer, which is basically used to calculate the crystalline size from the XRD data available. Now how XRD data is, that we will understand. What is the Scherer formula? It is basically D is equal to K lambda upon beta cos theta. Now here D is basically the crystallized size that we need to calculate. Obviously it is in nanometers, as we are living in the nano world, where in everything we are scaling down so as to achieve the maximum performance with the maximum efficiency. What is about K? K is basically the Scherer constant, which has a value of 0.9. Lambda is nothing but the wavelength of the X-rays. Obviously, hope you remember yesterday we understand and their range is in 0.5 to 2.5 Armstrong. Then so this is the typical wavelength that we took, 0.15 nanometer. Then theta is the peak positions, that is in radians, and beta is full width half maximum FWHM. So how we are calculating is, let us suppose this is the sample graph from an XRD that we obtain. Obviously it is in between intensity and 2 theta. How we are measuring it, say let us suppose we are getting a particular curve like this and so on. So these are the peaks. So it is say let us suppose this is 0, this is 10, 20, 30 and so on. So what it says that from the XRD data we need to find the peak position and FWHM. So let us suppose this is the peak. So for a particular, if we are curious about a particular peak, that which part this particular peak is from which material, or what is the overall relevance this peak has in this the sample graph. So we will look for the peak position, what is the peak, and then theta is the peak position. So theta will tell, let us suppose at 20 we are getting this peak, or say let us suppose 19 we are getting this peak. So this 2 theta is equal to basically 18. So this is the peak position. Then what is the overall width of this particular peak? So full width half maximum. So this is the full width and then half maximum FWHM. Basically we have a software called Origin that we most of the time use to calculate FWHM as well as the peak positions. But manually if we need to calculate, either we can use the calculator or we can calculate it in the Excel, Microsoft Excel. So once we are we will be available with the data of theta as well as beta, which is nothing but the FWHM, because K and lambda obviously we must be aware about the wavelength of the X-ray that we are using for the XRD. This is constant, this is the wavelength, and this is full width half maximum. Once we are available with beta and theta, we would be able to calculate the overall grain size, obviously, which is in nanometers. So this is all about Scherer formula, which is basically an application of the XRD. Thank you. Thank you very much.